Good evening, students. So in this video I will discuss one question which is very important. Which of the following metal is leached by cyanide process? Which of the following metal is leached by cyanide process? So we know that cyanide process is used for silver as well as gold. So what happens? The impure metal is taken and it is treated with cyanide. So the impure metal is taken, like impure metal, it can be written as M. This denotes M, denotes silver or gold. It is treated with cyanide, sodium cyanide, in presence of water and oxygen. It forms a complex of the type MCN42- plus hydroxide ion. So this complex is formed. It is called dicyano. If metal, whatever metal likes, if it is silver then argentate, if it is gold then aurate 1. Now this is treated with zinc. This is treated with zinc metal. Now zinc metal forms the complex with cyanide and the metal is removed. The metal is leached. So this gives the metal, and zinc forms a complex with cyanide, that is tetracyanozincate 2. So this method is used for silver or gold, since the option has only silver. So silver is the correct answer for this question. This was asked in BITSET and this was asked in all of the competitive exam. I hope you understood it, student. Now let's see the second question, student. So metal which can be extracted from all three, dolomite, magnesite and carnallite. So for answering this question, you need to know the formula of dolomite, magnesite and carnallite. So let's see the formula of dolomite. Dolomite, it is CaCO3, MgCO3. What is magnesite? Magnesite is MgCO3. Now coming to carnallite. Carnallite, the formula of carnallite is KCl MgCl2 6H2O. So if you look at all the formulas carefully, you will see that magnesium is common in everything. So magnesium is common. So calcium carbonate, magnesium carbonate, dolomite, magnesite is magnesium carbonate, carnallite is KCl MgCl2 6H2O. It is a double salt. So we see that magnesium is common, so the answer will be C. This was asked in BITSET and I have seen in the BITSET only this question, and any other exam I have not noticed, so you just see this question. Let's see the next question, question number 3. Semiconductor materials like silicon and germanium. So you know that semiconductor materials or semiconductors are those substances which have conductivity in between conductors and insulators. There are two types of semiconductor. One is called the pure semiconductor, also called intrinsic semiconductor, and other are called extrinsic semiconductor. So what happens, the conductivity of silicon and germanium are very, very low. So we need to mix some impurities. The process is called doping. So semiconductor materials like silicon and germanium are usually purified by, you know that when we extract a metal, seldom they are pure. So we need to refine the metal. We need to refine the metal to obtain the metal in the pure form. But for using metals for semiconductor, pure metal is not required. We require ultra pure metal. We require ultra pure metal, means of super purity. So that process is done by zone refining. So zone refining the process which is used for silicon germanium. Not only silicon germanium, it is also used for boron, gallium and indium. So these materials like silicon, germanium, boron, gallium, indium, these are purified by zone refining. Distillation is used for zinc. Liquation is used for tin. And electrolytic refining is used for zinc, copper, etc. So these are the purification techniques which you need to remember, student. For this semiconductor material like silicon and germanium, the correct answer is zone refining. And keep in mind that vapor phase refining. Keep this also in mind. Vapor phase refining, it is used for those material which can form a compound, and that compound can be decomposed. So if the compound is volatile, that they form, like Mond process is used for nickel. So Mond process is used for nickel, and Van Arkel process is used for
Van Arkel process is used for zirconium and titanium. Zirconium and titanium. Zirconium, ZR and titanium. So zirconium and titanium are treated with iodine. Zirconium and titanium are treated with iodine. They form tetraiodide.
And these are decomposed to give the pure metal. Similarly, in Mond process, nickel is heated with carbon monoxide. It forms tetracarbon and nickel zero, which is decomposed at higher temperature to give pure nickel. So Mond process is used for nickel, very, very important. And Van Arkel process is used for zirconium and titanium. So vapor phase refining is done for those. So I hope you understood, student, this third number. Now let's see, student, this question which is based on Ellingham diagram. This question which is based on Ellingham diagram gives energy versus temperature graph is given to you. The plot is given to you. One is for magnesium oxide formation, another is for zinc oxide formation, this is ZnO, and another is for carbon monoxide formation. Now there are three questions which I will answer based on this. What should be the temperature to make the following reduction process spontaneous? Zinc oxide is getting reduced by coke to form zinc plus carbon monoxide. Now, here coke is acting as a reducing agent. So coke can only act as a reducing agent when the line of coke is below the line of zinc. That can only happen beyond 1100 degrees Celsius. You can see in the graph that this temperature is 1100. So below the line is carbon and above line is zinc oxide formation. So that means carbon coke will be able to reduce zinc oxide to zinc above 1100 degrees. So 1100 degree, this is given in Celsius, market degree Celsius, it is not in Kelvin. So above 1100 degree Celsius, coke will reduce zinc oxide to zinc. So first question is done for you. I hope you this is clear. At what temperature zinc and coke have equal affinity for oxygen? So you see this the point of intersection, this point is almost 1100. So at 1100 degree Celsius, zinc as well as coke has equal affinity for oxygen, equal affinity for oxygen. Now, just above this temperature, coke will be able to reduce zinc oxide to zinc. Now, coming to third question, at 1100 degree, which reaction is spontaneous to a maximum extent? At 1100 degree, so you see that 1100 degree, what is happening here? So, magnesium line is below zinc line. Keep this in mind. At 1100 degree, the magnesium oxide formation, that is, it is more spontaneous. That means magnesium will be able to reduce zinc oxide to zinc. So at 1100 degree, which reaction is spontaneous to a maximum extent? Magnesium oxide coke. So this is not going to happen because at 1100 degree, this is below. So magnesium will reduce carbon oxide, not the other way. So your answer is zinc oxide plus magnesium will give zinc plus. So here magnesium can reduce zinc oxide at 1100 degree, because the magnesium oxide line is below zinc oxide line at 1100 degree. So therefore magnesium metal will be able to, because the formation of magnesium oxide is more spontaneous. So keep this in mind, student, you have to use this formula, delta G equal to delta H minus T delta S, to understand completely the Ellingham diagram. So this was the four most important question which I found from metallurgy. I hope you liked this, student. Do like and subscribe my channel for more such videos in future. Thanks for watching. This is Sandeep sir signing off.